गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल, होप यू विल बी सेफ एंड साउंड बाई द ग्रेस ऑफ ऑल माइटी अल्लाह। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन इंग्लिश ऑनलाइन क्लास। ऑन योर स्क्रीन यू कैन सी द पिक्चर ऑफ योर बुक, सो ओपन इट एट पेज नंबर 108। हेयर एक्सरसाइज डी वॉज गिवन यू एज अ होमवर्क, सो आई एम गोइंग टू रीड द क्वेश्चन, दैट इज़ यूज दीज वर्ड्स टू कम्प्लीट द स्टोरी। सम वर्ड्स आर गिवन टू यू टू पुट इन द ब्लैंक्स टू कम्प्लीट द स्टोरी। Now on your screen you can see the solved exercise. You have to take help from it if you have not done, and you have to put the I'm going to read the passage. Okay, long ago, about 700 years ago, a strict and cruel man called Hermann Gessler lived in the town of Altdorf in Switzerland. He was in charge and everyone was afraid of him. He set up a pole in the marketplace. He placed his hat on top of the pole and ordered people to bow to his hat when they passed. People always bowed because he would kill them if they disobeyed, except for one man. His name was William Tell. Okay, now come to the today's topic. Girls, we are going to start our next exercise, that is at page number 107. You can see the picture of your exercise on your screen. Now this exercise is about a preposition. Like, let me read the question. Complete the sentences using a suitable preposition. Okay, now bitte, you know well that preposition is a part of speech. Now how many parts of speech? There are 8 parts of speech: noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, conjunction, interjection, article and preposition. Okay, what is noun? Noun naming words are called noun. For example, car, girl, cat, school. Okay, pronoun, it is a word which is used in place of noun to avoid the repetition of the noun. Okay, like he, she, it or you. Okay, now the next part of speech is verb. Action words are called verb. For example, teaching, learning, reading, laughing, smiling, all these are actions and activities, so they are called verb. Okay, adverb. Adverb is a verb, a word which modifies a verb, that how the action is done, where the action is done and when the action is done. Okay, like neatly, politely, here, there, all these are adverbs. The next part of speech is adjective. Adjective is a word which modifies a noun or pronoun. It describes a noun or pronoun. For example, new car, intelligent girl, pretty woman, all these words which are modifying, which are describing noun, they are known as adjective. Okay, now go ahead. Our next topic, our next part of speech is conjunction. Conjunction is a word which joins two words, two phrases or two sentences. For example, you and me. Here and is joining two words, you and me. Okay, so it is conjunction. Interjection, the next part of speech is interjection. Interjection is a word which shows a sudden feeling. For example, alas, oh, ouch, all, hurrah, all these words are interjections. Okay, like we have won the match, hurrah, we have won the match. It is here, hurrah is interjection. Now the next and last part of speech is preposition. Okay, article. Second last part of speech is article. Articles are 3 in number. You can say them that they are used as an adjective in a sentence. Whenever our noun is started with consonant, we, and if it is singular, we are supposed to use a before it. If our noun is started with a vowel, we have to we are supposed to use an before it. Okay, and the last article, which is the, we are supposed to use it to specify something, to make something special. Now our last part of speech is preposition. Preposition is a word which tells the relationship of a noun or pronoun in the sentence with another noun or pronoun. It shows a relationship. It creates a relationship between noun or pronoun to the rest of the sentence, to the noun or pronoun, another noun or pronoun in a sentence. And now at page number 107, you are having an exercise. Some prepositions are given to you. But before solving this exercise, you people must know that there are some kinds of preposition. Okay, there are some types of preposition. You can see the picture of types of preposition on your screen. That the number one is simple preposition. If a preposition is of one word, it is called a single word, simple preposition. For example, at, in, by, at, under, behind, beside, up to, down, all these are having only one word. And they are used to create a relationship between noun or pronoun to the rest of the sentence. So they are known as simple preposition. Now, the second type of preposition, that is known as double preposition. In double preposition, we are having two words used as singular preposition, like without, within, throughout, into, onto, and instead of. These are known as double preposition. Now, bitte, on your screen, you can see that different uses of different preposition because students are always confused to use them. The first one, the very common, the common preposition, that is in. In is used to show some location, especially when you are in covered area. Like, you can take the example, I am in the classroom. So, classroom is covered area. So, in is used a suitable preposition over here just to show the location. Now, the second use of in is that it can be used for the year or the month. Like, I was born in 1999. Here, the year is mentioned 1999, so in it will be used as a preposition, okay? Now, it is used for the month. So, example is, our exams are in June. June is the month, so we are supposed to use in as a preposition. The next preposition is on. Okay, when something is placed on the surface of something, then we are supposed to use on as a preposition in a sentence. For example, I put my bag on the table. So now on is showing you the surface of the table. Okay, the third preposition is under. Underneath and below, all these are having the same meaning. They are used to show a lower place of any, a lower degree or a lower place. Okay, for example, I kept box under the bed. Okay, and the cat is under the chair. It means that the cat is sitting at a very lower place of a chair. It is, so under is a suitable preposition over here. The next preposition is up. Up is used as a preposition to talk about position at a higher level, okay? As well as it can be used as an adverb. He is going upstairs. Now here the point is going to be pointed out that it is showing as the place. So it is used here as an adverb, but it can be used as a preposition as well. He lives just up the road, okay? Where he lives? He lives on up the road, okay? Out, the next one is out and out of. They both have the same meaning. And it is used when we are supposed to talk about position or direction. We also use them for talking about movement from somewhere. Like they can be used that something is gone. Okay, for example, don't go out, it's too cold. Now here it is used as an adverb of place, okay? The next one is, the printer is out of ink. It means that ink is finished over there in the printer. Okay, Jay. Now, come to our exercise. Now you people have to see that I am going to read the statements. You people have to put a correct preposition over here. The question is, complete the sentence using a suitable preposition. Some preposition are given you in the block. Now, number one is, the horse jumped dash the fence. Fence is a border. Okay. Now, in picture, you can see that the horse is jumping from the fence. Okay. It is a border. It is a place where animals are kept to keep themselves safe from the attack. In movies, in cartoons, you people have seen it, okay? Now, what is a suitable preposition here? That is over. The horse jumped over the fence. Number two is, the children waited dash the car. As I told you that if we are in covered area, so in will be used as a preposition. The children waited in the car, okay? My mother put the dash the cat. My mother put out the cat. It means my mother put away the cat from the kitchen, maybe from the kitchen or from the room. Anaya put dash the umbrella. Anaya put up the umbrella. It means Anaya picks an umbrella over her. He went for a walk. We went for a walk dash the forest. Through is used to go through somewhere from one side to another side. Okay, here through is used as a preposition. We went for a walk through the forest. Number 6 is the man waited dash the front door. Whenever you are going to write something about doors, so at will be used as a preposition over there. So the man waited at the front door. The cat was hiding dash the car. It is very easy, that is under the car. The cat was hiding under the car. He wore the cap dash his head on his head. Okay. It is show that some surface was there and that was head. Okay. I stood with dash my mom in a queue. Queue means line. Okay. So what should be the appropriate and suitable preposition here? That is beside. I stood beside my mom in a queue. And the last one is my friend lives dash my grandmother. And the last option is that is near. My friend lives near my grandmother. Okay. Now, bete, we are supposed to do exercise B. Ring the preposition in the sentence and write the two nouns adjoins. Now, as you know that preposition is used to join, to create a relationship between a noun or pronoun in a sentence. So, you people are supposed to find out two nouns from the sentences, as well as you people have to encircle the preposition here. Number one is the man walked towards the house. Now here man and house are the nouns and they are connected. They are joined with the help of preposition, that is towards. So you people have to encircle towards. Already it is encircled. Number two is Maryam stood near the bus stop. Here Maryam and bus stop are the nouns and they are connected with the preposition, that is near. Number three is Jude climbed over the gate. Jude and gate are the nouns and they are connected with the preposition, that is over. The okay, so you people have to encircle over as a preposition and write Jude and gate as a noun in front of the blank spaces. Okay, ji. The number four is the bird built a nest in the bushes. The bird and the bushes are the nouns here, while in is the preposition. You have to encircle in and write bird and bushes in the empty spaces. Number five is the little girl is hiding underneath her blanket. Here, the little girl and blankets are nouns here and they are connected with the preposition, that is underneath. Encircle underneath as a preposition. Number last is the mouse ran into the hole. The mouse and hole are nouns here and into are used as double preposition here. So, you people have to encircle. Now, bete, I hope you people have understood it. Now, come to your homework that I am going to give you homework. That is at page number 107, exercise C. Write the sentence with a preposition to describe each picture. It is your homework. And you people have to do it on book, okay? Now, four pictures are given to you. You people have to write about each picture by using one preposition. Like in first picture, you can see that a vase is kept on the table. In second picture, you can see that a dog is jumping over a fence. And number three is, you can see the picture of a house and a tree. So, you people have to mention, describe this picture by using a preposition. And the last one is, you can see a cat is sitting somewhere. So, you people have to use that where the cat is. So, you people have to do this exercise by using a preposition and describe each picture on your book. Hopefully you people have understood all these things. Keep safe and assalamu alaikum. Goodbye. Thank you so much.